Hi dear students, welcome to Geeta's classes. Now let us see some problems on predicates and quantifiers. So what is a predicate? We have seen what is a predicate. So any statement which are having some variables for which if you assign some values it will become preposition or statement. Suppose if you have some x, y, z, some variables in the statements, and if you assign some values to these variables it will become a statement, then it is called a predicate. These x, y, z are called variables. Okay, then we can quantify these predicates, which is called quantifier. We have for all and there exist, two main quantifiers we have seen, for all and there exist. So if English statements are given, we can write in symbolic form, and if symbolic forms are given we can write in English. Those kind of problems will be asked. So let the universe be the integers and let capital N of x denote, this is the given question, N of x denotes x is a non-negative integer, E of x denotes x is even, and O of x denotes x is odd, and P of x denotes x is prime. So we have to find the logical notation for the following assertions. First question, there exists an integer. Please remember, N, capital N is non-negative, E means even, O is odd integer, P is prime. Okay, so find the logical notations. So there exists an even integer. Even integer is what? E of x. There exists an even integer. So there exists E of x. Very simple. Every integer is even or odd. So here, always remember, the universe is set of integers. For all these notations, universe, x is taken from the integers only. Set of all integers. So universe of discourse is set of integers. So every integer is even or odd. We know for even, E of x, odd, O of x. Either E of x or O of x. Which one? All the integers are either E of x or odd of x. Okay. So E of x is even, O of x is odd, and every integer is even. So this is for all x. Okay. This indicates that every integer, so for all x, either it has to be even or it has to be odd. Now, all prime integers are non-negative. All prime integers are non-negative. So here also for all x, okay. Here we have to write all prime integers. Prime integers means P of x, and non-negative means N of x. Can you write here R or and? We can't, because here if you take any integer, it is given even or odd. Here all prime integers are non-negative. So if you choose one prime integer, it has to be non-negative. If you select prime integer, it is non-negative. That means if P of x, then non-negative. Okay. So this is a conditional statement. For all x, for every x in the set of integers, if it is a prime, then it has to be non-negative. Okay, this is the given statement. And next is, there is only one, only even prime is 2. Only even prime is 2. So if you take E of x, the only even prime is, even number is x, and P of x. So what is the condition? It has to be even and it has to be prime. Then if this is taken, if you choose one integer, integer which is prime and even number, it has to be 2. So x is equal to 2. It has to be 2. Only possibility is 2 here. Okay. So every integer from the set of integers, if you take for all x, if you choose one x which satisfies these two conditions, if it is even and prime, then it has to be 2. Only possibility is 2. Therefore, e of x and p of x, then x is equal to 2. Okay. Very easy. Only thing is we have to think and write. That's all. Now, there is one and only even prime. There is one and only even prime. So, apart from for all and there exists, we have studied one more quantifier, that is unique quantifier. So, there exists a unique value e x such that it is even and prime. Okay. Now, we are using that unique quantifier. Right. Next is not all integers are odd. Not all integers are odd. Not you keep it aside. All integers are odd. How will you write? Odd. Odd means O of x. Right. All integers are odd means for all x, O of x. Very simple. Take negation. Not all integers are odd. Simple. Or if you take this negation inside, what will happen? For all will become there exists. Right, there exists x, not of O of x. This also can be written. Either you can write like this or write like this. There exists, or not all integers are odd. There exists one, at least one integer which is not odd. That is also another meaning. Okay. Now, not all primes are odd. Not all primes are odd. So, first you consider if there is a prime number, it has to be odd number. Okay. This is for all x. For all x, if there is a prime number, then it is odd number. Right. But it is not true. There is at least not all primes are odd. There are even primes also. We know that there is at least one even prime. Okay. Similarly, if an integer is not odd, then it is even. Integer is not odd. Odd means O of x, not odd of x. So, if this is true, then, if this is true, then it has to be even number. And this is true for all x. Okay. If it is not odd, not odd number, then it has to be even number. Right. Next. Use quantifiers to express the statement. There is a woman who has taken a flight on every airline in the world. So how can we write? There are two ways and this is not unique way to write. You can write your own statement also. So this is two ways I will tell you. P of, we are having a woman, a flight and every airline. So let us take W, F and A. Okay. So, P of W, F is the statement. W has taken F. That is, woman has taken a flight. This is the statement P of W, F with two variables. Okay. And Q of F, A is F is a flight. F is a flight on the airline A. So, F denotes, consists of all the women. Okay, F denotes women. All the women, set of all women. And here F is set of all airplane flights. Set of all flights. And A is all airlines. Okay, these are the variables defined. These are the domain actually. Okay. So, from now, these are the statements defined. W has taken, woman has taken a flight and flight is from this airline A. Right. But now what do you want? There is a woman who has taken a flight on every airline in the world. Right. So, there exists a woman. There exists a woman W. Who has taken from all the airplanes, okay, from all the airlines, from every airline. So, for all A, from all airlines, he has taken at least a flight. So, there exists F, P of, both has to be true, W, F and Q of F, A. This is one way of writing the statement, right? Or you can even make it simpler. Or you can write, you can define all the three in a same predicate, the R of W, F, A. So W has taken F on A. You can directly write. This is actually simpler. Okay. If you find this difficult, then you can go for two, or you can simply write this one. Three variables also will be easier. Then how will you write here? There exists a woman. There exists W. The same for all A from all the airlines. At least she has taken a flight from every airlines. So R of W, F, A. Okay, anyone you can do. Next is translate each of the following statement sentences into symbols. First using no existential quantifier and second using no universal quantifier. So you have to write in two forms. One should not contain there exists, one should not contain for all. Okay. So universal quantifier, existential quantifier is what? There exists, right? There exists X should not be there. And universal quantifier is for all X, right? So in one statement, you have to write all these statements in two different forms. In one form, you should not contain, it should not contain there exists. In another form, it should not contain for all X, right? So that is what you read again, translate each of the following sentences into symbols or symbolic form. First using no existential quantifier and second using no universal quantifier. So first is not all cars have carburetors, right? So first one, let us define car of X as X is a car. And carburetor, carbo of X is X has a carburetor. Okay. So what is the statement? Not all cars have carburetors. Not all cars have carburetors. So cars have carburetor. If it is a car, it will have a carburetor. So if there is a car, then it will have a carburetor. That is the statement given, right? Car of X, conditional carburetor of X. That is not all cars. Not you leave it aside. All cars have carburetors means for all X. If it is a car, it will have a carburetor, right? Now not, you include that not. So in one form we have written, that is here using for all X and there is no there exists, right? This is one form, right? First form. There exists is not there. Now the same statement you have to write without for all. You can have there exists. Okay, what will you do? You take negation inside. We have for all X, no? Take negation inside. So for all X will become there exists X. If you take negation, negating the statement, there exists X, then negation of, and this P conditional Q is what? P conditional Q is equivalent to not P or Q. This you have to remember. I told you throughout this unit, we will use this. Okay. So not negation of car of X or carburetor of X. That is, there exists X. Now again, you take, this is using De Morgan's law, you have to apply. So negation of car of X, it will become car of X, right? And R will become, and then negation of carburetor of X. So there exists X, here double negation will become car of X, okay? So there exists X, car of X, and not of carburetor of X. So here we have there exists, there is no. Here this is another one. This is first form, second form. There exists is there. There is no for all. Okay. So how will you write this actually? There exists a car, but it does not have a carburetor. There exists a car which does not have a carburetor. That is the statement here. If you want, you can write. There exists A car which does not have a carburetor. Okay. Next question. What are the negations of these statements? These kind of questions you can expect even for university exam. Some statements will be given. You will be asked to write the negation of the statements. So what are the negations of the statement? There is an honest politician. So first one, we will write H of X. H of X is honest. Always remember, you have to write in terms of X and you have to write the domain also. Here, what is the domain? Domain is the set of all politicians. Okay. Domain is the set of all politicians. For one question, I'll write everything remaining. You can follow that. So, H of X, X is honest. So, what is the given? There is an honest politician. So, there exists X, H of X. This is the given statement, right? Where the domain is the set of all politicians, right? Now, how will you write the negation? You are asked to write that this is the given statement you have written in the symbolic form. Please remember, whenever these kind of questions are asked, don't write exactly. Without writing the symbolic form, don't write from the English. It will become wrong. Okay. So, there exists H of X. So, negation means not of, there exists X, H of X. Right. So, this is equivalent to. Now, if you want to take negation inside, there exists will become for all X, then negation of H of X. Right. That means for all X, not of H of X. H of X is not what? X is honest. What is negation of H of X? X is dishonest or not honest, right? And for all X, that means every politician is dishonest. Every politician is dishonest. Okay. So, in English, generally we say all politicians are not honest. That is ambiguous. Okay, that will not give a clear picture. That is ambiguous, right? So, all politicians are honest and all, it will be giving different meanings, right? So, second one, all Americans eat cheeseburgers. So, B. So, let us write C of X, X eats cheeseburgers. Not Americans, Indians are also eating, right? No. So, C of X, X eats cheeseburgers. So, what is the statement given? All Americans eat cheeseburgers. So, what is the, here X eats cheeseburgers. Here the statement is all Americans. Therefore, our domain is all Americans, right? So, what is the given statement? For all X, C of X. For all X, C of X. Where the domain is? Domain consists of all Americans. That is the given statement. Domain consists of all Americans. So, how will you take the negation now? Negation of for all X, C of X. So, for all X will become, there exists, this is equivalent to. For all X will become, there exists X, not of C of X. Not of C of X. That means what? There is an American who does not eat cheeseburgers. There is an American. That is, there exists one X. So, there is an American who does not eat cheeseburgers. Okay. Or, you can say some Americans do not eat cheeseburgers also, you can say. Another way of telling is some Americans do not eat cheeseburgers. That is the negation of the statement. Next is all dogs bark. So, let us take P of X where X barks. And what is the domain here? Set of all dogs. Okay. So, what is the given statement? For all X, P of X. for all x p of x. What is the negation? Take negation of for all x p of x. It is equivalent to for all x will become there exists x not p of x. What is the meaning? At least some dogs do not bark, you can say, or there is at least one dog which does not bark. Some dogs do not bark. Or you can say there is at least one dog which does not bark also, you can say. Then D. What is the fourth statement? Cheaters never prosper. Cheaters never prosper. Let us say P of X. X never prosper. X never prospers. So here, what is the domain? Set of all cheaters, right? So what is the given statement? Cheaters never prosper. So for all X, P of X, where X takes the domain is the set of all cheaters. Set of all cheaters. Now, what is the negation? Negation is not of for all x p of x. That is equivalent to for all x will become there exists x not of p of x. That is there exists a cheater who prospers. Never, here x never prospers means it is they don't prosper, but here negation is they prosper. Okay, so there is at least there is a cheater who prospers. There is at least one cheater who prospers. You can say like this, or some cheaters prosper also, you can say some cheaters prosper, as we have written in the third sentence. Some dogs do not bark, in the same way here some cheaters prosper also, you can say some cheaters prosper. So let P of X be the statement. Next question, let P of X be the statement X spends more than 5 hours every day in class. Every day in class. I think we have left two questions here. No dogs are intelligent. Some numbers are not real. That also we'll do after this. Okay. So let P of X be the statement. X spends more than 5 hours every day. Every weekday in class. Where the here. Till now English sentences were given. We have written in symbolic form and take the negation and all. Now symbolic form is given. You are asked to write in the English sentence. Where the domain for X consists of all students. Express each of the these quantifications in English. So first one is there exists P of X. What is the statement P of X? X spends more than 5 hours every weekday in class. Okay. There exists X P of X. Means what? There exists at least one student who spends more than 5 hours in every 5 hours every weekday in class. So there is a student who spends more than 5 hours every weekday in class. Whatever is the given sentence, you write as it is. Only for this you have to be careful. There exists at least one student. So there is a student who spends more than 5 years. Now, for all X P of X, that means what? Every student is spending more than 5 years every weekday in class, right? For all X P of X. So every student spends more than 5 years every weekday in class. And one more thing, next is there exists X who is not spending. So negation of P of X. P of X is X spends more than 5 hours. Negation means what? They do not spend. So here there exists a student. There is a student who does not spend. Okay, you have to write that. Who does not spend more than 5 hours every weekday in class. The same thing here also. No student is spending 5 hours every day. Okay, that means no student spends more than 5 hours every weekday in class. Okay. Next is these two. I'll give you the answers. You can. No dogs are intelligent. Here I'll do wait. No dogs are intelligent. That means here dog a of x b dog of x. Let us take x is a dog. Then intelligent intel of x. Is x is intelligent. Okay. So what is that? Every dog, no dog is intelligent, right? What is the question? One second. No dogs are intelligent. No dogs are intelligent means what? Dogs, that is, if it is a dog, dog of x, it is not intelligent. So intelligent of x. So for all x, if you take any dog, it is not in. No dogs are intelligent. So for all x, if it is a dog, it will not be intelligent. So here we have used for all, there exists is not there. This is one form. Now we have to use negation. Sorry, there exists, but you should not have for all. So now from this, what we have to do is take double negation. Introduce here already the previous question negation was there, so we have taken inside. Here negation is not there because we have to change this for all to there exists, right? For how is it possible? Only by negation. Here no negation is available, therefore I am taking introducing two negations. Two negations. So negation of for all x, negation of, this is p conditional r, p conditional q means p r, wait, here negation of intelligent, if it is a dog, it is not intelligent, so we'll have one more negation here, okay, negation of intelligent, so p conditional q means not p r q, so not of dog of x, r, not of intel of x. Okay. Now you bring one negation to the to before and one negation after. So negation of this for all x will become there exists x, right? Then one negation you take it inside. So negation of dog of x, right? Already we have one negation. This negation I am bringing to the this side, bringing to the left hand side, and here I am taking inside. So negation of dog x. Then here again one more negation we have intelligent of x. Right? This is equivalent to negation of there exists x dog of x. And intelligent of x. So there exists a dog where it's a dog and intelligent, which is not possible. So negation of there exists at least one. There exists x dog. That is nothing is available like that. Here there exists without this negation. If you remove this negation, there exists a dog which is intelligent. Here it is not true that it is no such. Entity is available. Okay, that is the meaning. Next is some numbers are not real. Some numbers are not real. Once again, some numbers are not real. So that means let number of x. X is a number and real of x. Always you try to write them in the atomic form. Okay. So X is real. So what is given? There exists a number x and not real. Some numbers are not real. So not real of x. There exists at least one number x such that it is a number and not real. Okay. So here we have used there exists, but there is no for all. Now we have to bring it to no for all. There exists should not be there. Okay. The other form. We are asked to write in both the forms. So here introducing to negation, you introduce negation of number of x and not of real of x. That is, now you again, as we have done in the previous question, one negation you take it to the left hand side, one negation to the right hand side. So negation of there exists will become for all x, then negation of number of x or real of x. What is this PRQ? P conditional Q. So not for all x, number of x implies real of x. Okay. So this is the form. Here we have for all x and there exists is not there. Right? And we have, as we have done in conclusion, premises and conclusion, the theory of inference we have done for ordinary statements. The same thing is there for quantifiers also. That we'll see in the next class. Thank you so much for listening.